Yeah, we welcome you one and all to the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. This is a marriage of two of your favorite TV games. I'll be hosting the Match Game.
And later on, I'll be handling Hollywood Squares.
Why don't we go to work, John?
Okay,
we
shall we?
We have an aisle seat for
After
you
me.
Over here. I hope it'll be satisfactory. Now, would you join me in greeting our stars? Hello, stars.
Thank you.
Arsenio, I suspect you are a natty dresser every day of your life.
Well,
He looks natty today, doesn't he?
I'm no Gene Rayburn, okay? I try. I'm number two, and I try hard.
Are you all ready to have a go at it?
Yes. We finally got a dressing room.
Yeah, you did?
Where? Yes. We're downstairs, nine of us in a room.
Better than being in the parking lot.
No, I know.
I think it was a good party. Why are you complaining?
No,
we've been having fun.
I had fun. I know that.
It was?
Yeah. You Carl don't... helped me out with my boots. And...
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, she did say boots, didn't she?
Yeah, boots. Right. We must enunciate clearly here, Shannon.
She has a diphthong. It's,
let's all say hello to Pat Hobbs and Diane DeMarco. How do you do?
Hi.
Let's get acquainted, Pat.
Okay. I'm a marketing rep for a major insurance company in this area. I'm a freelance photographer, amateur, and I also like to sew.
All right. Did you make that?
Yes, sir.
Stand up and let us see what it looks like. I think it's a great talent for a woman to be able to do that. Good for you. All right, Diane, tell us about you, please.
I was born and raised in beautiful Burbank, downtown California.
Oh, you're right at home here, aren't you?
Yeah, and I teach drama and English at Burbank High.
All right. Good luck to both of you. Let's begin the game. Here on the Match Game, the object is to match as many of our celebrities as you can. We're going to play three rounds. The contestant who's matched the most celebrities at the end of the game will be the winner and go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Here we go with our first round. And, Pat, you won the toss, so you have a choice here of A or B.
I'll take A, please.
A it is. For Pat Hobbs, Sammy the songwriter used to be a surgeon. Instead of "I want to hold your hand," he wrote, "I want to hold your blank." Major will be finished in a moment, Pat, and then we'll get your response. All right. Sammy the songwriter used to be a surgeon. Instead of "I want to hold your hand," he wrote, "I want to hold your blank."
Brain.
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 I want to hold your hand. All right. I want to hold your brain. Arsenio, what came to your little mind?
It's definitely small and getting smaller as I write. I have patience.
I want to hold your patience. He didn't get the idea, did he? Well, listen, this is a hard game. It's not as easy if you sit at home there and you prejudge everything. It's easy when you're at home, but it's difficult when you're up here. Right, Nidra?
Right.
What did you have?
Your chest.
Why did you say that, Nidra?
Well, it's sort of a nice thing to do.
Oh, sure it is. I want to hold your chest. no.
Okay.
Just mumbling to myself.
I want to hold your pen. That pen?
I want to hold your pen. Uh-huh. All right.
What a vicious crowd. Where are these people from? I want names.
Sammy the songwriter used to be a surgeon. Instead of "I want to hold your hand," he wrote, "I want to hold your..."
Well, I would have thought this was the definitive answer because it applies and it rhymes and it's a little risque.
Glam. That's it. I want to hold your glam. Very good. Very good, John.
I play a doctor. I was thinking of a femur or a thorax or something.
I want to hold your
but
thorax.
That doesn't rhyme, so I said gland.
Yeah, attaboy. Thank you, Dr. Begley.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right, Charles.
My eyes are bad, but they're not that bad. Gland.
All right. Okay. This first round is just really to kind of get the hang of it for the two of you, and we do hope you'll get it. Louis said, "That salesman told me this vacuum cleaner would pick up the worst filth in the house. He was right. It just sucked up my blank." Ready there, Arsenio?
Well, just a second.
Okay, Diane.
Go for it.
What? Chuck. He's writing his autobiography. Doing a little artwork.
was the winter of our discontent. Wait a minute. It was the best of times, it was the worst of times.
All right. Diane. Louis said that salesman told me this vacuum cleaner would pick up the worst filth in the house, and he was right. It just sucked up my blank.
Undergarments.
Well, I suppose things are the only change.
So much for our date over there. I mean, our date's off.
We had plans.
Yes, I know it. I know it, but it's the end, right? Arsenio.
I said wife, and I tore it up, and spouse, and I tore it up. I went with husband. Sucked up my husband.
Louis, you didn't, did you? Louis said, well, I live in L.A.
It's the thing.
Oh, yeah. I see. All right.
I'm trying to relate.
What do you got there, Deidre?
My mother-in-law.
Mother-in-law is a good response. Good answer. They love you. We all love you. All right, Shannon.
My wife.
That's another good response. Salesman told me this vacuum cleaner would pick up the worst filter of the house. He was right, just sucked up my...
If you knew Louie like I knew Louie, it would be his wife.
All right.
I thought Louie was a vacuum cleaner salesman. I said husband, too. I'm short-circuited today.
I'm really? Like beef.
I thought the Hoover guy was named Louie or something.
Would you like to sit down here next to him?
No.
Together. Sorry.
Hello, Chuck. This the price is right. It's my eyes. Sorry. Definitive answer, the porno X-rated cassette, two Janes and a Jean, or two. Right out of the library.
Well, we have a very creative, imaginative bunch here, and we'll get back to them in a moment or so, right after we pass on these messages to you. The first round. And as you can see, we have a zip-to-zip game going here. And we'll go into the second round now. And since she went first last time because of the tie, we ask you to go first this time, Diane. You want A or B?
I'd like B, please.
B it is. You may have B. Liz Taylor loves music. Liz Taylor's a music. You, as a music major, should know that. Her favorite song is We Shall Over Blank.
Don't
worry, I love this. Yeah. No hints, Shannon. All right. About ready, everybody? Here we go. Diane, Liz Taylor loves music. Her favorite song is We Shall Over Blank.
We Shall Over Wed.
Over Wed? Yea, verily, she did that in her lifetime. We overwed. There are other good responses here, too. Let's see if Arsenio has one.
First thing that came to my mind was we shall overwed, but it's such a stupid answer, so I put E.
We shall overeat. All right.
Well, thank you.
That's a great... I really and truly think this is a match, Gene.
Really?
If you say it in, I'm going to punch you right in the nose.
Now, wait a minute. Deidre, I am not the judge. I'm only the middleman.
Well, I'll get him.
I will tell you who to punch.
I'll get him later.
Get him later. We shall overmarry? Oh, yes, indeed. I will say that. One for Diane. Good for you, Deidre. Would you like to do a chorus of We Shall Over...
We talk here.
E? There it is. Another one. Oh, no, I beg your pardon. Diane, you have one. Let's see what happens here. Liz Taylor's favorite song is We Shall Over...
I said We Shall Over Way.
We Shall Over Way. We Shall Over Way.
There's a reason for this answer I have here.
What is that?
I don't know if you know. She just had her ears pierced.
Oh, she did?
Yeah. And gravy came out. But that's a cold joke. I'm sorry. I don't want doing that. Everyone's taking shots.
Yeah,
she's wonderful. I'm sorry. I went, my first choice was wed, but somehow I said eat. I'm sorry.
All right. All right, Charles, are you going to do something for Diane DeMarco?
We got too many in the room now.
Oh, all right.
I think it's the judges, I think they have to really consider that. I think it's a man.
Close.
Wed.
Well, isn't that a nice surprise? You picked up two there in round two. Let's see if that keeps up with you here. George says, I'm not saying that my neighbors are unneighborly, but their welcome mat has a blank on it. Has blank on it. I beg your pardon. Thank you, Bobby. But their welcome mat has blank on it. Yes. Listen, I got to show you something while we're waiting. We had a problem here with the heat.
Coming from
her. Where is he?
Where did he go?
Remember last week? Remember last week we had all that smoke coming out of the pit here? Well, they got this big pipe here, and they're blowing in cold air that comes out of the lights up there. Isn't this a great gadget? Come on, I want one of those for my house. Are you ready over there? I'm waiting for you. Okay. Here we go. George says, I'm not saying that my neighbors are unneighborly, but their welcome mat has blank on it.
Not welcome?
Not welcome?
Not welcome, man.
Don't think she's going to keep up with you, Diane. Let's see what happens. Arsenio.
Oh, I actually had a neighbor that had a gun on their welcome mat.
A gun?
It was frightening, but...
All right.
They're from my neighborhood.
Nidra, show us what they got her giggling.
Get lost!
You're pretty cute, Nidra.
Only coming from her. That's so funny.
All right, Shannon.
I wrote, go away.
Go away. I've seen those. Neighbors are unneighborly. Their welcome mat has what on it, John?
I said scram.
Or scram!
Jackson's welcome mat beat it.
Very interesting trivia. Steve Allen actually has Get Lost on his welcome mat.
He does.
I think he does. But I matched you, unfortunately. I said scram.
Yeah. Are you saying that you're a friend of Steve Allen?
No.
You've been to his house? Yes. You just hang around his doorman.
No, I heard that, though, from a close personal friend of his.
All right. Here we go, Charles.
I'm just making a list of people that Ed will never be able to see again. Liz Taylor, Steve Allen, I'll keep it right here.
The producers of the show.
I want a stupid 40, a 40s answer, safe for children that are watching, and semi-adorable.
Yeah.
In fact, it stinks. Skunk.
As a picture. No, that would be nice if all of a skunk.
Someone gets called.
All right. So there we are at the end of round two. Diane's ahead, 2-0. Round three, the final round coming up right after this. Third and final round. I want to point out Diane's ahead 2-0. This is the third and last round, and Diane, since you're still ahead, you have to go first.
I prefer B again.
All right. It is yours. Ruth says, my husband is so formal, he's the only man in the world who wears a tuxedo to blank. Very formal color. Either you don't write, and Chuck, you don't write. Because you matched in the previous round.
Good thing I don't.
Can't think of anything?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you can't? Well,
nothing you can say.
That's right.
All right. Guess we're about ready. Come over here to Diane. Ruth said, my husband is so formal, he's the only man in the world who wears a tuxedo to blank.
To bed.
To bed. Very good. Your gesture of futility indicates that you did not say to bed.
I thought gland would be a good answer, but I said bed.
Oh, you did. All right. So you're up to three, Diane. Shannon, what came to your mind?
Well, I thought bed would be a good answer.
Very good. Splendid. Formal husband, the only man in the world who wears a tuxedo to bed, according to everybody.
To bed, to bed.
According to John Dew. 5 for you, Diane. 1 to go. And who is it?
It's Ed. To dinner? No, to bed, of course.
Of course. All right. Now, Pat, the best you could do is achieve a tie. And in order to do that, you must match all 6 stars on this question. Mary says, the policeman that gave me the ticket was a real weirdo. Ooh, he didn't tell me to put my hands over my head. He told me to put my blank over my head. Perfect.
Excuse me.
Waiting for Nidra.
No, wait.
Well, now she's ready.
Terrible.
All right, Pat. Mary says the policeman who gave me that ticket was a real weirdo. He didn't tell me to put my hands over my head. He told me to put my blank over my head.
Feet?
My feet? Feet. That would be difficult, wouldn't it? It would be very hard. Now, you got to match everybody, remember? All six over here. Arsenio, she says feet. What do you say?
My friends, Andrew, they looked at me and I had to change it. So I had legs.
Legs. One. All right.
Yeah,
all you need is five more. Got to get them all. Nidra.
I'm sorry.
Skirt.
Skirt. Very good answer, but that means Diane wins the game. Come on down here, Diane. All right, you're going to be playing the Hollywood Squares in a few moments. Say goodbye to you, Pat. We're going to send some gifts your way. Many thanks to you, Pat Hobbs, for being here on the Match Game. All right. Congratulations. It's timed out a switch to Hollywood Squares, and here comes the rest of the set. Don't bump into them. It stops just at the right time every time. That's really remarkable. And we're going to have three more celebrities coming out here in a moment. I'm going to change places with the host of Hollywood Squares, John Bauman. So we invite you to stick around here. Don't go away. Lots more excitement. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Gibson Variable Speed Wash Master Automatic Washer, designed to save time and energy, plus matching automatic dryer with vacuum dry system for energy-efficient drying power furnished by Gibson. And some of our departing contestants will receive Whistman's Stir Crazy Automatic Caramel Corn Maker, fast and easy to use because it stirs itself with great-tasting popcorn, caramel corn, and cheese corn. Black & Decker Scrub Brusher, the cordless rechargeable scrubber with the power to get you through your worst scrubbing jobs around the house. Scrub Brusher from Black & Decker. Clothing by Dobie. Share your special feelings with Care Bears Kids Wear. All over the Care Bears in soft, lovable styles. Care Bears Kids Wear by Dobie. The new Norelco Chic Cordless Ladies Razor for fast, close, comfortable shaves. Comes with a handy travel case, too. It's chic from Norelco. Silverstone on Steel by Bake King. Easier food removal, faster cleanup. Silverstone on Steel by Bake King. The crowning cut to bakeware today. And now, it's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Squares. Power. Laverne and Shirley, Eddie Mecca, from We've Got It Made, Bonnie Urseth, and Fred Travellina. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Squares,
Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, and a very special welcome to our three new celebrities. We have Fred, Eddie, and Bonnie. Fred, Eddie, and Bonnie. Fred, a little Travellina music. Got anybody up there in your square with you today?
Well, I brought along Jim Neighbors. He has the most terrifying story I've ever heard. He told me a story about a sergeant that he knew that was really, really egotistical, and he forced this young girl down the south to spend the night with him and woke up in the morning and said, "Sweetheart, in 9 months' time, you're going to have a baby. You can call it Clem if you like." And she says, "Sergeant, in 3 days you're going to have a rash. You can call it prickly heat if you like." That was one of the strangest things I've ever heard.
Okay. More from Fred and his friends a little later. Meanwhile, I have with me Diane DeMarco. She has just won the Match Game contest. Now she's ready to take on our returning champion, Duke Battle in Hollywood Squares. Come on, let's go. Our returning champion, to my right, is Joseph Hunt. He is returning so far, having accumulated the grand total of 1,725 smackaroos. Attaboy. Pretty good day for you yesterday. Why don't you remind us a little bit about your life today, 25 words or less.
Okay, John. I'm an airbrush artist for motion picture special effects, and I've been studying acting for about 2 years now.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good luck to you today. Let's play Hollywood Squares. And we're going to play Hollywood Squares until you hear the Time's Up bell. Whoever is ahead at that time is our winner. Goes on to play Supermatch for up to $30,000.
Ooh.
Okay, our first game is worth $100 plus $25 for every square that either of you capture. Our champion has the privilege of starting. Joseph, take a look at the board. Pick a square.
Charles Nelson Reilly, please.
Oh. Oh. That's you. Charles Nelson Reilly, researchers have discovered that because a certain animal loves pizza and beer and tends to overeat, it's the ideal animal to use in their study of humans. What kind of animal is it?
Pizza and beer? Animal.
Right.
The cow.
Okay, Charles says that a cow loves pizza and beer and tends to overeat. Agree or disagree, Joseph, for the first square?
I'm going to disagree.
The answer is a pig. You are right to disagree. You get the first square and 25 bucks. Okay, Diane, your move.
Gene Rayburn?
Gene Rayburn.
Yes, sir.
Turning the tables, asking you a question. Watergate conspirator G. Gordon Liddy, Gene, says that listening to this man gave him the first feeling of hope in his life. Was he referring to Billy Graham, Richard Nixon, or Adolf Hitler?
Well, I was not in his corner at any time during those historic events and momentous events. I believe because of the nature of his character, he was inspired by Billy Graham.
Okay, so Gene says it was Billy Graham who inspired G. Gordon Liddy. Agree or disagree, Diane?
I agree.
The answer is Adolf Hitler. You should have disagreed, and Joseph gets the square. Okay, Joe, you're in a commanding position.
Ed Begley Jr. to win, please.
Ed Begley Jr. for the first game. Ed, which came first, the Perry Como Show or Valium?
Same thing.
How do you know this? Back then, it was Milltown. That was the pill that was taken back then for the same thing. Valium came later. The Perry Como show came first.
Okay, so he says the Perry Como show came before Valium. Joseph, for the game, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
The answer is the Perry Como show. You're right to agree. You win the first game. Darn it. Very sweet. Three X's up there. You got $175 so far. Nothing for you, Diane. But we will be right back to play our $200 game in a minute. Stick with us. Stay tuned. For more of the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. Now, back to John Bauman and the Hollywood Squares. Thank you. Our next game is going to be worth $200, and again, $25 for every square that you capture. Diane, you graciously lost the last game. That means you get to start this one. Pick a square.
Eddie Mecca.
Good. Okay, good. Eddie Mecca.
Ball.
Eddie, you're a woman in pretty good health.
Excuse me?
I'll repeat that. You're a woman in pretty good health.
Oh, you're talking about Fred over here. I don't have to take this. I have a home in Fire Island. All right, thank you very much.
Eddie, you're a woman in pretty good health.
Okay.
According to the book, questions patients most often ask their doctors, how often should you see your gynecologist? Once a year or every 3 months?
My wife is in great health. She sees the doctor once a week. So what's the question again?
How often should a woman see her gynecologist, according to this book? Once a year or every 3 months? Yeah. If you're in pretty good health.
I'd say every 3 months.
Okay, so he says every 3 months you should see your gynecologist. Agree or disagree, Diane?
I agree.
The answer is once a year. No, you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets the square and $25. Okay, Joseph Hunt, make your move.
Ed Begley Jr., please.
Ed, which has a longer life, the average light bulb or the average house fly?
Which has a longer life?
Yeah.
Okay. A light bulb is about, an average is about 100 hours. That's average. Some of them are more, some less. A house fly, I think, is just 48 hours. So I'd say the light bulb.
So you say the average light bulb has a longer life than the average house fly.
It is house.
Okay, Joe. Agree or disagree?
What did he say again?
He said, I don't know. Did you know that? He said the average light bulb has a longer life, yes, than the average house.
I'll agree with that.
And the average light bulb does, and you get the script. Yes. The average light bulb has a life of 42 days, and the average housefly has the meager life of only 28. Aw. Okay, Diane, take a look at the board. It looks like you have some place you have to go.
And Nidra to block, please.
Nidra to block. If you miss this one, Diane, Joseph takes another game. Okay, Nidra. Nidra evolves. More than half of the women recently surveyed by Playgirl magazine said they would enjoy sex better if they had a more attractive what? A more attractive body or a more attractive partner?
Well, speaking personally, my husband isn't a bad looking guy, you know. So I would say a better boss.
Okay. So Nietzsche says that women would enjoy sex more if they had a more attractive body. Agree or disagree, Diane, to block?
I disagree.
No, it's if they had a more attractive body. You should have agreed. Your opponent gets the square and wins the game. Okay, Joseph, you have won yet another game, and you're up to $450. Still Zippo for you, Diane, but we're going to clear the board, and we're going to move right on to the next game. This one is worth $300. Joseph, since you won the last one, Diane gets to start once again.
Bonnie, please.
Bonnie Ursa, you have put on a little weight, and your husband teases you about it.
I didn't think anyone knew.
Have I struck on? Doesn't look it. If you are like most of the women surveyed in Glamour magazine, does this encourage you to diet, or does it make you eat more?
Absolutely, it makes you eat much more.
Okay, so if you put on a little weight, she says it makes you eat more. Agree or disagree, Diane?
You about it.
I agree.
It encourages you to diet, according to Glamour magazine. You should have disagreed, and your opponent gets that square. Joseph, make your move.
Fred Travellino, please.
Fred Travellino.
Freddy. Yeah.
Which lasts longer, an episode of Star Trek or a trip to Jupiter at the speed of light?
Hold it, excuse me. Run that by me again, Fred.
Which lasts longer, Fred, an episode of Star Trek or a trip to Jupiter at the speed of light?
Trip to Jupiter, I would say, well, Mr. Spock, beam up. I would say an episode of Star Trek.
Okay, it says an episode of Star Trek lasts longer. Agree or disagree, Joseph?
I will disagree.
An episode of Star Trek does last longer. No, you should have agreed. A trip to Jupiter lasts only 33 minutes. An episode of Star Trek lasts 1 hour. And we'll be back to complete this game right after this. Joseph Hunt, you got $475. 25 so far for you, Diane. Diane, it's your move. We're in the middle of a $300 game.
Arsenio?
Arsenio Hall. Is the beaver monogamous, or does he like to fool around?
He's a beaver?
Girls are goofy.
Typical beaver question.
You say, is the beaver?
Yeah, is the beaver monogamous, or does he like to fool around?
We're speaking as in Cleaver.
I'm worried about the beaver.
Yeah, the kid. Cleaver.
Oh, well, just says, is the beaver monogamous, or does he like to fool around? I guess it's the animal.
I think we're talking about the animal, maybe.
Yeah, because beaver was too little. Okay, probably grown up.
The animal.
What about Lumpy?
What about
the beaver is monogamous.
Okay, the beaver is monogamous. Diane DeMarco, agree or disagree that the beaver is monogamous? He is monogamous. You're right to agree, you get the square. Okay, Joseph, you going to try to stop her?
Sure am. I'm going to go with Gene Rayburn to block.
Gene Rayburn to block. If you miss this one, Diane will win a game. Beginning next year, Gene, all new cab drivers in New York City will be required to learn how to do something. Must they learn how to deliver babies or how to be courteous?
Well, they've had a great drive on to improve it, and Mayor Koch has been especially active, and he's been leading that fight. To get the cab drivers to be a little more courteous, especially during the tourist season.
So Gene says that cab drivers in New York are going to have to learn how to be courteous. You agree or disagree, Joe?
I don't know if it can be done, but I'll agree.
Yes, it is. They must learn to be courteous. Get the square and you walk. Diane, he's put you in kind of a compromising position. Where would you like to move?
Nidra, please.
Nidra Vold. If you miss this one, Joseph will take the game. Here's a question about banks, Nidra. Which came first, the drive-up teller or the sperm bank?
Could you rephrase that, please?
I just read what's on the card.
I wouldn't really have anything to do with either one of them myself. But I think that the sperm bank came before the drive-up teller. Are you talking about those little things where you put the card in and...
You're talking about the sperm bank now or the drive-up teller?
Don't they have them both where you can make nice deposits?
Yeah, you mean the drive-up teller where they put the card
in. The
early withdrawal.
You're talking about the people that can drive their car up there and... I would like to change my answer, sir.
Okay.
I would like to say that the drive-up teller became more prominent. Well,
before.
Not after. Yes.
Okay, so the drive-up teller came first before the sperm bank. Agree or disagree, Diane DeMarco, to block?
I disagree.
The drive-up teller did come first. No, you should have agreed. Your opponent gets the square and wins another game. You're on a tear, Joseph. You have 825 smackaroos so far, $50 for you so far, Diane. Let's clear the board, and we're going to start another one. This one's worth $400. Diane, once again, you have the privilege of starting.
Shannon, please.
Shannon Tweed.
Hi.
If a man and woman are sleeping together, Shannon, who is more likely to be... who is more likely to be awakened by a sudden noise?
Well, now,
sleeping men that have had sleeping, they don't wake up for any. Not in any.
We don't want to hear about it, Shannon.
I'm going to say that the woman does, because the only frames of reference I have are old movies where, there's somebody in the house. You know, I don't know.
Right.
Yeah.
So she says that...
I think it really, the woman is more sensitive to scary noises and things like that.
She says that the woman is more likely to be awakened by a sudden noise. Agree or disagree, Diane?
I agree.
And the woman is more likely. Women are lighter sleepers than men. Get the score. Joseph, pick a star.
Okay, Gene Rayburn, please.
Gene, you're popular today.
All right.
As always, of all sports played around the world, Gene, which has the fastest moving ball?
Say again, please.
Of all sports played around the world, which one has the fastest moving ball?
It's a very old, old sport. And it's played with a small, hard, rubber ball. And it's the name of the game is squash.
Okay, so he says that squash has the fastest moving ball. Joseph, agree or disagree?
I disagree.
Hi-a-lai has the fastest moving ball. You are right to disagree. You get the square. Yes, you're perfectly correct. That should be an X behind G. Well, you're paying attention, aren't you? Because there's money at stake. Okay, there we go. Diane, your move.
Bonnie, please.
Bonnie, you're set. Which is older, Bonnie, Medicare or the miniskirt?
Well, the miniskirt was the 60s, and Medicare was the 62 when Johnson came in. Which part came first? I'm going to say Medicare, a little bit.
Okay, she says Medicare is older than the miniskirt. Agree or disagree, Diane?
I agree.
The miniskirt is older than Medicare. Joseph gets the square. Okay, Joseph, your move. You have a very logical one.
Yes. Nidra Vold, to win, please.
A very logical person.
Go, Nidra.
Nidra Vold for a game win. Which has been around longer, Nidra? Lucille Ball or the ballpoint pen?
I've been around longer.
You're not one of the choices.
Not one of the choices. Well, I think Lucille's a very nice lady, you understand?
Mm-hmm. How do you feel about the ballpoint pen?
But I really think she's been around longer than the pen. I think.
Okay, so you say Lucille Ball has been around longer than the ballpoint pen. Joseph Hunt, for yet another game, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
The ballpoint pen has been around longer than Lucille Ball. Yeah, you should have disagreed. Your opponent gets that square. Yeah, the pen was invented in 1888. That bell means time's up. With $875, Joseph Hunt, you're once again our champion. Joseph, once you go over there, join Gene Rayburn, get set for your shot at still some more big money. And we are sorry we have to say goodbye to you, Diane. You played well. You are leaving here with $100, and you're leaving here with our thanks for being such a good contestant on Match Game Hollywood Squares. And now, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, John. Our congratulations to Joseph here. We'll be back with all of our 9 celebrities and a go at the big money right after this.
Time now for the big money super match, where you can win up to $30,000. Are you ready for it?
Yeah.
If you wanted another chance to get up here, you
That's
got
right.
it.
That's right. That's right.
Here we go. We polled the studio audience not too long ago, and we said, give us your best response to this. Blank raid. The top answer is worth $1,000, the second most popular $500, and the third answer $250. Now, you can get some help from any 3 of our 9 celebrities here to give you suggestions, and you can call on them one at a time. Whom do you want first?
Ed Begley Jr., please.
Eduardo.
The obvious, I think, is Air Raid, is it not?
Air Raid is one. All right, that's from Ed.
Okay. Charles Nelson Reilly.
Yes, sir. Vice Raid. Vice Raid. You go to many of those, Charles?
Thursday night was the
okay.
last.
Okay.
Bonnie herself, please.
Panty raid.
Panty raid. That was a popular sport in the 60s, was it, or the 50s? I've forgotten.
Before Medicare, I think.
Never ended. Never ended. I don't think so. All right. So you have air raid, vice raid, and panty raid. And you can choose one of those or give us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
I'm going to go with air raid.
Air raid. All right. I see if air raid is up there, and if so, where? We'll begin down at the bottom and take a look at the $250 response. Police raid. There's one answer. All right, the next one says... Panty raid. All right, that was Bonnie's answer. Let's see if air raid is up there under the $1,000 response. Go. Yeah! You got it. All right, Joseph, you're on your way now. So far, you've got $1,000. Now you're going to play the head-to-head match with any star you pick. Now, you'll notice each star has in front of him a hidden number, a 10, a 20, a 30. If you pick a star with a 10, we multiply your money by 10. If you pick a star with a 20, you will multiply your money by 20. And there's one star up there with a 30, and if you pick that one, you'll play for 30 times your money. All right? Make your pick.
Bonnie, please.
All right, Bonnie?
Yes?
He's chosen you. Let's see your hidden number. A 20. A 20. That means you're playing the head-to-head for 20 times $1,000 or $20,000. There it is. Bigger than life. Here we go. I will get the question for you, Joseph.
All right.
Face me if you would, please. Bonnie, you'll write your response and put it in the slot when you're finished. And at this stage of the game, it must be an exact match. Blank games. Blank games. No help from the audience, please. If we hear an answer, we'll have to throw it out and do it again. All right, Bonnie's ready. Joseph, it's up to you to match her for $20,000. What do you say? Blank game.
Olympic.
Sight of the Olympic Games in 1984 here. Bonnie, he says Olympic Games will match you for the $20,000. What do you say?
I thought of the movie War Games.
War Games. War Games.
Hey, that's my friend.
Yeah, watch it. Now, what is your total here at this point? A total of $3,600. That's not bad. Not bad.
All right.
And you're still up here as a reigning champion. You're going to have another go at it. And we'll come back in a moment and find out which celebrity has the big 30. Hurry back.
Would like to be a contestant on the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, just send the postcard to Contestants, the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour, 6430 Sunset Boulevard, Hollywood, California, 90028.
Well, here we are. We've just been standing around here talking. Bunch of the guys standing around on the corner talking.
Oh, why not?
And, you know, with movies so popular, we've had so many movie titles as answers to questions here. War Games was not an illogical...
Did you think of War Games?
Well, the Olympic Games was good.
This is the site of the Olympic Games, and it would... anyway, we want to all find out right now which celebrity had the big 3-0. So, John, would you step back to your seat?
I'll never be 30.
And all of you grab your tabs and reveal them at the same time now. Charles Nelson Reilly had the big 3-0. 30, that would have been 30,000. You would have been playing.
Dress, we can send a present.
That is today's session of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. We'll be back tomorrow with our champion here and all of these beautiful 9 celebrities. I'll be here for the Match Game.
And I will be here for the Hollywood Squares.
Hold on to the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour. Join us tomorrow.
A member of our studio audience will receive Quasar combined the miniaturized radio cassette unit with a compact headphone stereo. The result is the stylish and versatile double play, furnished by Quasar. And some of our departing contestants will receive Super Seal food savings at stores everywhere. Independent test shows Super Seal keeps food fresh as the more expensive home party brand. Save money by Super Seal. Uncle Ben's international flavored rices, chicken, beef, bird, and pilaf. When only the best will do, say Uncle Ben's. Post 40% brand flakes. If you want better tasting fiber, it's Post. The best tasting 40% brand flakes. Sandwich bait slices. Use sandwich bait in all your recipes to call for American cheese that costs less than American cheese, too. Introducing Pecan Clusters, another special candy bar from the makers of Heath English Coffee. If it isn't special, it isn't Heath the candy specialist.
Tonight, it's the best in comedy and drama with Gimme a Break, Mama's Family, We Got It Made, and Emmy winners Cheers and Hill Street Blues. Be there.
This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. A Mark Goodson, television production.